Now, we have certainly, among our many programs in Bolivia, we have known that there is a correlation between public order and respect for law and order and progress, social and economic progress. In connection with that, many years ago, the Bolivian government asked us to help them in the organization and training of their army. Consistent with the plans developed then, we have had a program over the years of training and limited military assistance. When the guerrilla outbreak came, we had already laid on a plan for a training program for what is now known as the Second Rangers. That would have happened possibly by the end of this year. Because of the specific threat which the guerrillas represented, we accelerated that program. We started the training about 5 months ago. We completed it about 2 months ago, which means a 3 month training program for the guerrillas, for the rangers. And then, of course, we have since, at the invitation of the Bolivian government, had a group training additional so-called rifle companies.
This is the American-run school of anti-guerrilla warfare. Establishments like this have angered those in Latin America who accuse the Americans of setting themselves up as policemen of the world. But they are undeniably effective. Within 12 days of completing their training, these Bolivian rangers got Che Guevara.
Just how long have you been searching for Che Guevara, and in which countries have you been searching for him, as it were?
Well, we have different people in different countries, you know, working all over, especially in Latin America and Southeast Asia and down through that way. And many of us, you know, in some of the areas that we've been in before, and never could find him, or he's always a step ahead of us. But here, I guess his luck run out. Them little Indians just ate him up. Thank God.
Are you sorry in any way, sir?
No, I'm not sorry. I'm proud. I thank God for his help, too. I think he was a professional soldier. He was a good man. He believed in his way, and we believe in our way. But like the United States and so forth and all these other countries, we ain't buying communists and they ain't moving in. And they're not moving in the States, not if I can help them. Or any country that wants their freedom.
Mejor, compañero.
Americans have long regarded Latin America as their own back door, and they intend to keep an American foot in that door. So what chance does Master Sergeant Milliard give the guerrillas in the future?
A guerrilla war, in my opinion, is hard to terminate. Because once you wipe out their main people, their auxiliary, and their leaders and so forth, they'll go underground till they get more leaders, then they'll come back up again. And this is problems, what we call a problem area. And then what we try to do is solve it. If we can solve it by helping the people out, then we do it. If not, then we get some of our technicians or our specialists and see what they can do about it.
One specialist who made it his business to be present when Che Guevara's body was brought in was this man. His name, Felix Ramos. He entered Bolivia as a Cuban businessman. More likely, he's a member of the American Central Intelligence Agency, the CIA.
So what is Bolivia's future after Guevara? President Barrientos knows his problems.
If the governments are going to be justice, I don't think we'll have any guerrillas. But especially, not only depends on Castro, depends more than Castro from ourselves. We have to be very in hurry not to permit the people to be so poor.
And for myself, I want only to keep on, to go on, to get on fighting and trying to serve the revolution in Latin America. But that's very difficult from a cell, you know. You can't do many things.
Perché non hai dato bugiare a tuo figlio con tuo sangue nel mano? Perché tieni che hacerme este daño a mí?
The misery of people like these is raw material for revolution. This man, Federico Escobar, a communist and miner's hero, died just a year ago. Unlike Guevara, he was a Bolivian and is still mourned in defiance of official disapproval. If a leader like him stakes his claim before President Barrientos wins the fight against poverty, Bolivia could face its 181st revolution.
So I stood like I could be good and bring her back. Oh, but I'm so empty now, and lesser somehow. I don't have the heart. Don't.